and for many, it's been a significant loss, obviously. But and there was a lot of uncertainty. But Wisconsinites are resilient and are innovative, and the folks at Lake Geneva know that well. So just as we drove in, lots of folks here. Wisconsinites have been able to stay flexible, innovative, and adapt to the challenges brought by this pandemic. That's why when we received the first federal funds, the CARE Act and from the federal government, we put that money to work right away. We helped more than 14,000 households. We helped out 15,000 farmers in the state of Wisconsin and 35,000 small businesses and restaurants with our We're All In grant program. And we invested more than $50 million in the tourism, lodging, and entertainment industries as well. And those funds made a huge difference. As a result, our state is recovering. Our unemployment rate is back to pre-pandemic levels, which was pretty low. I think we're about ninth in the country right now. Actually, our unemployment rate is a full percentage point lower than our neighbors in Minnesota. And we recently announced that our state coffers are expecting $4.4 billion more than what we anticipated. So our work is going well, but it is far from being done. That means we really have to take advantage of right now. If we're going to move not just move back to where we were pre-pandemic, but actually move forward and propel our state forward to build the kind of future that we know that we can do, and it's time to make smart, strategic investments in our money, in our people, in our industries that will build a much greater future than we had before. So today, I'm here to announce that we are going to use more than $140 million of our American Rescue Act, Plan Act funds to bolster and support the entertainment, lodging, tourism, and travel industries in the state of Wisconsin. That includes $75 million for our lodging industry, more than $11 million for our movie theaters, $22 million for our live event venues, nearly $3 million for our minor league sports teams, $8 million for summer camps, $1 million to assist the Historical Society getting their 12 sites up and running in a good way. In addition, $15 million for destination marketing organizations and more than $7 million for the Department of Tourism to assist in these efforts. So whether it's from hotels or event venues, summer camps, minor league teams, these folks make up, all of you make up a huge important sector of our state economy. And all of you know this data. National research shows that 87% of Americans plan to travel this summer. They plan to stay longer, and they plan to have more people in their company than in their parties than ever before. So as folks in Wisconsin and around the country begin vacationing and traveling again, it's especially important now more than ever that we support these vital industries so that we don't just recover, but we do better than we were before. So thank you for being here today, and now it's my pleasure to introduce and hand a microphone over to Acting Secretary Ann Sayers from the Department of Tourism. Ann, you're up.
Thank you, Governor. I could not be more excited to be here in Lake Geneva for this big announcement today. From leisure travelers looking to reconnect with friends and family to business travelers attending meetings and conventions, these dollars are crucial to helping our industry bounce back. I cannot wait to help more travelers get out there and experience the unexpected here in Wisconsin. I want to thank Governor Evers for his continued commitment to tourism and to our industry. Tourism is such a large part of our economy, and the governor's commitment to tourism runs very deep. Since long before he started this job, actually, the governor and his wife have what I think is one of the most Wisconsin tourism traditions I've ever heard. They have visited the Wisconsin State Fair every year since they've been married. And is it even before that, too? It was since you're dating? Yeah. I love that. And just like the State Fair is coming back, the visitors are coming back as well. Economists predict that tourism spending will not fully recover until 2024. And we're pleased that Wisconsin appears to be tracking ahead of the national average early on in this recovery. And while the tourism recovery will be a dial and not a switch, we are encouraged that leisure travel is setting the pace. As the governor mentioned, 87% of Americans plan to travel now in the next 6 months, and we are already seeing them choose Wisconsin. In fact, early data shows that those overnight trips are not just outpacing the pandemic year of 2020, but we're actually outpacing 2019, which was a record-setting year for tourism in Wisconsin. So it's really good to see. You know, one of my favorite parts of being in this acting secretary role has been reaching out and connecting with our industry partners. I've had, just recently, I was in Janesville last week for the tour of America's Dairyland, up in La Crosse to visit a distillery, and in communities across the state, I'm hearing the same thing and I'm seeing the same thing. The visitors are coming back. They are looking to make those memories. They're choosing Wisconsin communities across the state to do just that. I'm sure you're seeing it as well. So the data backs up these observations. It's bouncing back in the leisure tourism space. But while leisure tourism is resuming, business travel is a little bit slower to return. And there's work to be done to help all facets of the economy bounce back stronger. And that's exactly what this infusion of funds is going to help us do. Wisconsin's hospitality industry is the heart and soul of our communities. And don't just take it from me, take it from the guests as well, who when they talk about their experiences in Wisconsin, they talk just as much about the people they meet along the way as the places they visit. And the first people they interact with are hospitality workers who love our state and represent the best of us. Today, I'm joined by so many of those fantastic people who know hospitality well and have represented our state proudly throughout their careers. We're in a really strong position at the Department of Tourism, and I'm proud to have led a team that has done the great work of pivoting throughout this pandemic that's prepared us and the full industry for this moment of recovery. And a big reason that we've been able to operate from such strong footing is due to the leadership of previous secretaries, one of whom I had the distinct pleasure of introducing today. She's been Miss Wisconsin, she's been the host of Discover Wisconsin, and the former Secretary of Tourism. Please join me in welcoming Stephanie Klett, President and CEO of Visit Lake Geneva.
Thank you. Thank you, Anne, for this meeting. Thank you. She's a sweetie, I like her. When Governor Evers walked in, I didn't shake his hand. I've never met him. I hugged him because that's what we do in the tourism industry. And I said, here in Lake Geneva, we are caffeinated and fully vaccinated. So it's an honor to have you and Anne here. Thank you so much. Just so you know, it's such a big deal that you're here. We didn't have a lot of time to put this together. So thank you, Tammy Carstensen, for moving on it. But we have every person in this room is a special dignitary. But I do want to give a big hello to our mayor, Charlene Klein, our city administrator. I saw him earlier, Dave Nord. Where are you, Dave? There you are. Oh, it's in the back. Yeah, you know to hide. We have many of our city council members here. Tourism Commission, our chair of the Tourism Commission is here. We have the Visit Lake Geneva team here, if you would raise your hand, and our awesome, dedicated Visit Lake Geneva Board of Directors, if you just kind of raise your hand. And last but not least, I do want to single out our chairman, Dave Sekiris of Visit Lake Geneva, and his cohort in the hotel business, Michael Lucero from the Abbey Resort. Michael brought all the pastries and the coffee, so thank you very much for that. Most important. With you here, Governor and Secretary Sayers, we wanted to brag just a little bit about Lake Geneva. Oh, yeah, you know it. You know it. We've always been the place that the world turns to for extraordinary vacations. In the last couple of years, Lake Geneva has received some serious national accolades. We were named Best Small Town in the U.S. for Adventure by USA Today. We were named by Thrillist.com as 10 Best Lake Towns in North America. And Reader's Digest just named us, as well as the Grand Geneva Resort and Spa, as one of the best destinations in the United States to experience 4th of July. We've hosted television crews from the Today Show to CBS This Morning. And let's see, I see Barb Krause here. Now, this wasn't so much tourism, but kind of, because they were looking for a second home. Barb's sister was just the star of a House Hunters Lake Geneva episode, so we are really proud of that. And Bill Gage, who is the owner of the Lake Geneva Cruise Line and many other things, Bill had auditions for the Male Jumpers. I would love to see the governor
Next year.
Do that. Yes, all in favor. Now that would generate some earned media. But you may never come back. So, but Bill, these jumping, you know, auditions and tryouts are so well publicized. So you were just featured on Inside Edition and Good Morning America. So tourism is a big deal here. We are a city in Lake Geneva with a small population, but a big command of the tourism world. It's big business. We know that tourism in Wisconsin is over $20 billion, but here in Walworth County, with a population of 110,000, we're looking at, the $785 million. I'm going back to the 2019 number because we're surpassing that, as you mentioned, and not 2020. Because in 2020, all 72 Wisconsin counties were down, and there is nothing that any of us could have done with that. It's a once in a 100 years pandemic. But because of tourism in Walworth County, it ranks us, out of 72 counties, number 6 in total travel expenditures. And that's something to be proud of, because we're competing against Milwaukee County with millions of residents and Dane County. And our little 110,000 people are crushing it. And that's because we offer an experience like no other. And there's always something new here. Just think of the last month, what's new in Lake Geneva. Number one, we have the new poppy sculpture that is dedicated to those who served in the United States. We have the state's first indoor glamping venue. So forget camping in a yurt, you're indoors glamping. That's the way to do it, ladies. Am I right or am I right? We have two new giraffes at Safari Lake Geneva. We have a magician, Tristan Crist, who does a new show every year and makes a helicopter disappear, and you're 5 feet from him. I don't know how he does it. And, of course, Yerkes Observatory is undergoing a $90 million renovation. Yerkes Observatory is home to the world's largest refracting telescope. Albert Einstein paid it a visit, and, of course, Carl Sagan studied there. So a quarter of the U.S. population, their first job was in tourism. And here in Lake Geneva, it's a lot more than that. You can double or triple it. But it's important because customer service is a lost art. And many places throughout this country, customer service is not good. When you are treated well, like we treat you in Lake Geneva, you're coming back. And the more times you come back, we know you're more likely to buy a second home here, to get a little condo or a big place on the lake if you can afford it, and just look at it as a place that you get to call your own forever. In Lake Geneva, our travel and tourism industry professionals are constantly looking for new talent, and the group in this room mentors new talent all the time, and it's really great to see, because that doesn't go on in a lot of places. And lastly, Lake Geneva, we all know, is a special place with special people. We got through COVID together. COVID hit tourism harder than any other industry in the United States. And here in Lake Geneva, we had several restaurants that fed their furloughed employees and sent home food for their families. We had hoteliers that operated at a loss in order to keep employees working. We had merchants that gave local residents gift cards and discounts to help keep businesses afloat. We are an extraordinary place with extraordinary people. So with that, extraordinary people, I have the pleasure of introducing our last speaker and our host for today's event. She is a former Lake Geneva Citizen of the Year, and she is a force of nature. So please welcome Tammy Karstensen.
Well, I have to tell you that I didn't even know what I was saying today. I said, what do you want me to talk about? But most people in this room know that just give me a little bit of time and I can talk about anything. So first, let me just say that this is an absolute honor to have you here with us today in Lake Geneva and at Harbor Shores. As all of you were driving in, no matter what direction you came in, I'm sure that you noticed that Lake Geneva is full of action. Everywhere you look, we have music, we have magic, hot air balloons, award-winning golf courses, our amazing lake and lake path, boat tours and rentals, classic car rentals, scooter rentals, a safari, foodies. We have the most amazing restaurants, cooking classes, and let's not forget the shopping with the most unique stores. In Lake Geneva, sky is the limit. So welcome to our community, a place that we call home. I'd like to touch on a few topics that are very near to my heart, and it pertains to teamwork. Harbor Shores is one of the very few hotels that stayed open during the pandemic in the start of March 2020. Management took on the role of front desk answering calls, cleaning rooms, common areas, and maintaining the building. We were at risk of running out of funds, but we were both fortunate and grateful to receive the first round of PPP funds to bring back our entire team. We invested in iWave purifiers, new Calgon units, Victory sprayers to sanitize and kill any sign of COVID-19. We were able to cover the cost of these items and all of the PPP requirements throughout the pandemic from the generosity of our governor through the All-In grant. And I cannot express how grateful I am to the government for funds needed during our uncharted times. And this is a sign of true teamwork. Lake Geneva thrived through the pandemic and safely, thanks to the teamwork at City Hall. People, I stand here to present change. If we don't all work as a team, no one wins. Stephanie Klett has been a huge proponent in putting Lake Geneva on the radar. She's brought us together to work as a team, and a team that I am so proud to be a part of. Lake Geneva isn't just tourism, it's community. We thrive in a way that people want to move here. Changes are made to make every person living here feel welcomed and appreciated, whether you're a tourist or you're a homeowner. I personally love Lake Geneva. I love living Lake Geneva and always try to do my part in promoting Lake Geneva as a great place to stay, dine, shop, take advantage to complete your bucket list. Visit Lake Geneva has come full circle as a year-round destination because of all of you. And when I say all of you, I mean Visit Lake Geneva partners, our amazing police, fire, Mayor Klein, our alderman, city administrator Dave Nord, and yes, our governor is a part of our force to make Lake Geneva a destination where tourism now dominates the local economy. Why? Because we're already known for our scenic beauty, luxurious resorts, and historic mansions, but now we are so much more. The synergy here is contagious. Again, we're so excited to have you here today. Okay, I'm not going to lie. We would have liked a little bit more than 24 hours. But make no mistake about this. I did not do this alone because I have an amazing team here at Harbor Shores. And without this great group of people, I wouldn't be here today. They are my rock. Without a lot of people in this room, partners, city authorities, Visit Lake Geneva, we could not have made this amazing event happen today. In life, the only way to make a difference is to rely on each other. When one succeeds, it spreads like wildfire, and we all succeed. And Stephanie, as you finish creating the story of Lake Geneva, I would just love to add that we are a strong community of leadership, values, and compassion. We are a team, Governor, and we're honored to have you as part of our team today.
It is great to be back today, and we'll take some questions from the press in a minute. I just have to talk about the jumping off the boat piece.
All right, it'll be early June. Then.
Okay. Just remember, I've had 3 surgeries on each knee, so if you just get a little closer.
Anyway. We'll go slow and close.
Yeah, and I'll get the knees repaired. I can't wait to do that. This is a special place, and I know it's been an extraordinarily difficult year, but it is one of those, you know, hopefully one in a century deals, but it's also one of those pieces where people do come together locally, and it's clear that Lake Geneva is one of those places. And I've had a chance to spend a lot of time up north since the pandemic has wound down, and I hear the same sort of feeling that people have in the tourism industry and how they helped each other. They, you know, obviously that sometimes they're competitors, but at the end of the day, they pulled together and really did some really unique and innovative things to survive. And so I'm just glad to be here today to talk about how we can help that move along. So with that, I'd be glad to answer any questions from the press.
And Governor, the tourism industry businesses here in this community, I think, are facing the same challenge that a lot of people across the state are, and that's to find workers. They're thrilled that the visitors and the customers are coming back, but the workers aren't. There may be thousands of job openings in the tourism industry right here in this community. How do you address that?
Well, you know, I know part of the addressing is thinking about unemployment insurance, and I've got that bill on my desk, and I'll take a look at that. But I'm concerned that that is not the answer. I think we need to learn from this pandemic that we need to, and you've got it here. The idea that we have to have a high quality of life to make sure that we continue to bring people to Wisconsin to live and work, and you know, the trajectory of the number of people that live in the state and births and everything else, and there's not much government can do or anybody in this room can do about reproduction. But the fact of the matter is, we need more people in the state of Wisconsin. And I have the opportunity as governor many times to visit, especially with our neighbors to the south and the governor from Illinois. And he always talks about how nice it is that our folks here in Wisconsin go across the border and buy marijuana and help his coffers. And I talk about people, frankly, that come to Lake Geneva year-round from and actually have second homes in this area. And that's, I just think we need to, I don't think it's going to be solved at this moment, but we do need a long-term discussion about immigration. Certainly that's one of them. That's not something the state can control. But what we can control is quality of life. And that's the reason why the quality of life is so strong here, is that people like this pull together. And we need to kind of replicate that across the state of Wisconsin. So people do, we need more people in the state. We really do. The number of jobs completely outstripped the number of people that we have available to fill those jobs. So we're doing good things, but we also have to think long-term. And that is, in my opinion, investing in quality of life, whether that's around housing, whether that's about transportation, whether about education, and tourism, obviously. But it's a long-term solution. We'll do whatever we can. I know that Bill's on my desk. We'll look at that today. But I'm a little skeptical that that is the answer. Yes, sir.
Two questions real quick, Governor. Republicans are proposing massive tax cuts in the next state budget. Without seeing the budget document, what type of tax cuts, if any, are you supportive of?
Well, all those things are going to be playing out over the next week. And there will be a more definitive question or answer next week. Absolutely have not seen any of the documents because they haven't passed the budget. I understand where they're going, and we have actually reduced taxes in the state of Wisconsin by over $1 billion in my first year or two as governor, and then another $400 million during the pandemic. So it's not like the state has been a tax cut free zone. It's been, you know, we've been doing good work with that, with the Republicans on that. So I guess the straight answer is we'll wait and see. The document is not yet finalized, and the language makes all the difference in the world.
On another subject, yesterday President Biden called on cities to use federal COVID relief funds to help address an uptick in violent crime. Would you encourage local governments to use these funds for this, or would you open using state funds instead?
Well, that's a great question. I think the what they see nationally isn't necessarily an epidemic here in Wisconsin with significant violence. Obviously, there's too much. Any is too much. But the fact of the matter is, I am more inclined to spend any relief funds on the industries that make our state strong and have suffered the most. And that's why I'm here today. We made it a priority last time. We're going to make it a priority this time. If there are some areas where we can make a dent in that arena, yes, but I would say that's probably more, the locals are in a better position to make that decision than me. So I'm going to continue to get behind the folks that suffered the most in the pandemic. That's my goal.
Last question. Following up with the first question, obviously a lot of people are coming into the state, which is great news, but it seems like tourism businesses don't have the proper staff. Do you have any concerns that they might be overwhelmed
Well, not being a tourism official or running a business, a tourism business in the state, hard to answer the question specifically. But as I said before, I think we need to take a long view on this rather than making an assumption. You know, I'll address the income tax or the unemployment issue directly. No one has given me the data. I know there's going to be all sorts of folks that can tell me, here's my story. But the data doesn't exist that says these people could be working and they're not. Every person that is getting unemployment insurance right now, payments, they check in on a regular basis, a weekly basis, and we expect them to be searching for jobs, and if they're not, we remove that benefit from them. And we'll continue to do that. So my comment is more about we'll do whatever we can short term, but we have to look long term on this issue.
Governor, real quickly, just one more. Can you give us your thoughts on the voting bills that were sent to you? Is there anything in them that you would support?
Haven't read them personally, and we just got them yesterday. My problem all along has been I'm, as everybody in this room, pro-democracy, and we're better off in the country when we convince as many people as possible to vote. And if there's things that prevent them from happening, prevent that issue from happening, that's a problem for me. So I'll go through every one of the bills, but it is a concern of mine that we shouldn't be dissuading people from voting. We should be encouraging it. It's part and parcel of our democracy.
Thank you.
Thanks, everybody. Thanks for being here, everybody.
Apparently you are still helping me. I'm not in the